Philip Downham. Well, today our reading is Genesis chapter 14, and we've got a story about how Abraham rescues Lot, who gets embroiled in a war, and Abraham has a great victory. I want to focus in on Abraham's character, because I had always remembered that he tended to lie, and I've been quite disappointed about that, really. But in this particular story, we see how incredible his love was for Lot. And so I want to talk about that a bit. I want to talk about his holiness. You know, God says to us, be holy because I'm holy, in 1 Peter 1:16. And I think that's what we see here Abraham doing as he avoids contact with pagan influences in the area. And also I want to talk about God's support for Abraham and encouragement when he encourages Abraham to do the right thing. So, and also we've got the mysterious Melchizedek who appears, the high priest. But let's look at Abraham's character. It's just incredible how loving and patient he is towards Lot. Now, Lot is his nephew, and in the previous chapter, because both Abraham and Lot have so many animals and so many workers, they have to actually separate. They can't live on the same bit of land and not too nearby. And so they have to decide where to go. And Abraham says to Lot, you choose where you go. Which is very unusual, because as Abraham was the elder, he was the uncle, he should have had the choice. And Lot just goes along with it. He doesn't say, oh, uncle, why don't you choose? It's your right. He goes along with it. And he chooses the land that on the surface looks like the best land. It is Sodom and Gomorrah, so we know better. Unfortunately, it's a really tragic story in many ways. But at this point, it looks like the best land. He gets himself into trouble. And Abraham just immediately gets himself organised and goes and rescues Lot and his family and his possessions and has a great victory. So I was really, really impressed by that. I thought this man really had the love of God in his heart, because it towards other people, because it reminded me of the parable of the prodigal son. And that is in Luke chapter 15, and very well known. A son gets his inheritance early from his father. He just disappears, wastes it all. There's great distance emotionally between them, and then he decides he's done the wrong thing. He comes back, he says sorry, but his father takes him back basically as if nothing had ever happened, and he's extremely generous towards him and actually goes to meet him. He doesn't hang back at all. And that's a picture of God's love for us. Whenever anyone turns to God, the absolute total generosity and kindness and forgiveness. So we should always remember that and always turn to God in all our need. Then going on to the holiness, Abraham could so easily have taken the spoils of war, which he was offered in this story by the king of Sodom. But he says no, and he just doesn't want any connection whatsoever, and he doesn't want people to think that the king of Sodom has made him rich. It must be seen that it's his God who supports him. So that's another wonderful thing. And then finally, God actually reminds Abraham, just before he refuses any involvement with this pagan behaviour, God sends Melchizedek. Now Melchizedek, some say it was Jesus appearing in person for a brief period. Some say that it was a Gentile ruler who also worshipped God. He was worshipping the true God, and he's mentioned in Psalms and he's mentioned in Hebrews. But the important thing is that he says to Abraham in verse 20, blessed be God Most High, who delivered your enemies into your hand. God Most High, who delivered your enemies into your hand. And I think this is partly why, when Abraham was tempted to come closer to Sodom and the king of Sodom by taking these very tainted spoils, that he partly remembered, because he'd been reminded by Melchizedek. And I think this is what God does for us. He's always there. If we're a Christian, he's there as the Holy Spirit in our heart, reminding us of the things, you know, coming alongside, reminding, encouraging, teaching, guiding, and we have him with us all the time. And as a non-Christian, very often God will whisper things to non-Christians. And if, you know, that you're somebody who hears, you think God is speaking, respond and ask him to speak more clearly. So I think all in all, you know, quite unusual story in some ways, but very, very encouraging, and particularly how God is our guide and our defender, and he is the one who delivers our enemies into our hand and delivers us from our enemies. Bless you. Bye bye.